The following screencast describes the ASTM E2737 test setup and system performance test using a duplex Phantom placed in a universal inspection system. In this example, an existing scenario called test is selected to be modified. First, select the detector settings you will use in this scenario. Next, select a detector setting for lag test with an exposure time which exceeds the shutoff ramp and set up KV as used in your scenario. Setting up the burn-in test. Position the duplex Phantom with its thin material edge in the middle of the screen. Position the two regions of interest, one of them inside and one outside the duplex Phantom. Now you have to set up the tube current and the integration of frames according to your application. Acquire the image. After that, place the line profile on the duplex wire correctly and the spatial resolution will be calculated. Position the duplex wedge for the IQI evaluation and acquire image. Perform a grayscaling so that the 1T or 2T is clearly visible and zoom in digitally. Mark the hole, here the 2T1, and run the calculation. Continue with thick material. Perform grayscaling and digital zoom. Mark the hole with a circle. Select IQI thickness and target GBV and run the calculation. Position the duplex Phantom to display a sufficient homogeneous area within thin material. Place the first and the second region of interest. Continue with thick material. Acquire image. And place again the two regions of interest, this time, of course, in the thick area. That's it! Within a few minutes, a specific test scenario was taught. The next part shows the CEO's workflow qualifying the system. First, the supervisor selects the specific test scenario according to energy, FDD, and so on. And then the test specification, here the baseline performance test. The baseline test begins with the offset evaluation of the detector. Several steps of exposing, weighting, and sequence observation are necessary for the lag test. Manipulation has to be confirmed by joysticks and moves to predefined position. The burn-in test is necessary when using detectors with cesium iodide scintillator. After confirmation by joystick, manipulation sets a geometric magnification and moves to duplex wire IQI as taught before. The line profile is placed automatically. Again, after confirmation of automatic movement, the ASTM E1025 or E7042 IQI holds are evaluated. Image registration is performed to detect the holes. This procedure is done for thin and thick material. Now the manipulation moves to measure SNR in the predefined areas. Of course, also in both material thicknesses of the duplex Phantom. The bed pixel report form pops up and indicates the total number of pixel, clusters, and bed lines, as well as size and position of the clusters. After entering the limits, the status is processed automatically. Now, the system test result form pops up, which is defined in the ASTME 2737. It contains all measured parameters describing core image quality, material thickness range, and detector degradation. The limits to be set are typically 20% worse than measured with new components in the imaging chain. Finally, a PDF is generated automatically, which makes archiving of performance tests and process checks more convenient.